Daniel 7, the four winds of heaven. Daniel 7, 1 in the first year of Belshazzar king of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of his head while upon his bed. Then he wrote the dream and told the sum of the matter. The year is approximately 552 BC. Nebuchadnezzar had died about 9 years earlier and Nabonidus was king. However, he appointed Belshazzar, his son, as co-regent, and for the next 11 years Nabonidus was away in Temim, northern Arabia, while Belshazzar ruled in Babylon. Daniel has spent some 50 years in Babylon and he is now almost 70 years old. In this introduction, he makes it plain that the dream he received was more than a mere dream, it was a vision. It is part of the great prophetic revelation of God's program from Babylon to the end of Earth's sinful history when Christ will establish his righteous kingdom. Daniel 2. Daniel spoke and said, I saw in my vision by night, and, behold, the four winds of the heavens drove upon the great sea. The great sea, takes us to the Mediterranean. Joshua 1, 4, 23, 4, Ezekiel 47, 20, the sea around which the civilization spoken of in the Bible rose and fell. But the sea can also have the symbolic application of a sea of humanity. Ezekiel 26, 3b, will cause many nations to come up against thee, as the sea causes his waves to come up. Isaiah 17:1-13, woe to the multitude of many people which make a noise like the noise of the seas, and to the rushing of nations that make a rushing like the rushing of mighty waters. The nations shall rush like the rushing of many waters, but God shall rebuke them, and they shall flee far off. Daniel saw great wind-driven waves crashing on the land, the picture of unrest and powerful forces rushing in for mastery. Then he sees something emerging out of the foaming surf. The four winds of the heaven, this signifies the four points of the compass under the heavens. Jeremiah 49:36, four winds from the four quarters of heaven, these winds strove, creating the picture of winds clashing into very stormy conditions. Winds also mean spirit or minds and breath, and since they are the four winds of heaven, this gives the imagery of intellectual beings who received their breath and their intellect from God. Compare with Ezekiel 37:9, yet failing to acknowledge God, though given opportunity to do so, are striving for the dominion over nations, peoples and kingdoms. It is interesting that the striving winds produce great kings that seek to gather all nations under their dominion, but in the Grecian Empire the wind seeking to solidify all the regions is broken and sent back to the four winds of heaven. Daniel 8:8-11:4, note also that in Revelation 7:1-3, the angels are holding back the four winds, not of heaven this time, but of earth. When they let go, it is no longer winds, but a wind, singular, under one spiritual power that will cause devastation upon the earth. This devastation, by this last attempt for dominion by a spiritual earthly power, will scatter God's people to the four winds, but when Christ comes, Matthew 24:31, he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds. Daniel 7:3-4, great beasts came up from the sea, diverse one from another. Four beasts of prey emerge. These beasts are feared in real life, and their symbolic meaning is also to register fear and to warn of aggressive behavior. Daniel 7:17 tells us what they stand for. These great beasts, which are four kings, which shall arise out of the earth. The kings are defined as kingdoms in verse 23. From the wind, driven waves, four major powers would arise and seize domination. Arise from the earth, in verse 3 they rise out of the sea, while in the interpretation they arise out of the earth, verse 17, the sea, being symbolic of the ceaseless motion of the nations and peoples, the interpretation is more literal as the kingdom is established on the earth. This chapter focuses on dominion, earthly human dominion. Daniel 7:6, dominion was given to the leopard. Daniel 7:12, the beasts, they had their dominion taken away, yet their lives were prolonged. Daniel 7:26, judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion. Daniel 7:27, and the realm and dominion, and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven, shall be given unto the saints. Christ's dominion. Daniel 7:14, and there was given him, Christ, dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion which shall not pass away, and his kingdom, that which shall not be destroyed. Dominion is often depicted in the Bible as being over the earth and the sea. God created the heavens and the earth and the sea and is ruler over them. Man seeks to have dominion over the sea and over the earth, and in Daniel 8 the horn reaches up into heaven itself to seek dominion over things pertaining to heavenly things as well. So we see these beasts of prey striving for dominion like an awful game of King on the Mountain. Who is the King of the Mountain? Daniel 7, 4 The first was like a lion, and had eagle's wings. I beheld till the wings thereof were plucked, and it was lifted up from the earth, and made to stand upon the feet as a man, and a man's heart was given to it. The lion, symbolizing Babylon, declares himself King of the Mountain. But the lion lost its strength. Babylon was a golden city of advanced architecture, culture, and science. Neo-Babylonian Kingdom 612, 539 BC. Daniel 7, 5 And behold another beast, a second, like to a bear, and it raised up itself on one side, and it had three ribs in the mouth of it between the teeth of it, and they said thus unto it, Arise, devour much flesh. Media-Persia now sends the mountain to declare himself the king of the mountain. Its lopsided shoulders identifying it as composed of two powers, Persians and Medes. The three ribs representing three major conquests. Persian Kingdom 539-332 BC. Daniel 7-6 After this I beheld, and lo another, like a leopard, which had upon the back of it four wings of a fowl. The beast had also four heads, and dominion was given to it. With speed, typified by the four winds, this Grecian leopard pushed other powers aside and sat upon the mountain to enjoy his season of dominion. The four heads symbolized the four major divisions of the Greek Empire after Alexander's death. His kingdom was given to four of his generals that took four areas: Lysimachus, Greece; Cassander, Macedonia; Ptolemy, Egypt; Seleucus, Syria. Grecian Empire 332-100 BC. Daniel 7-7 After this I saw in the night visions, and behold a fourth beast, dreadful and terrible, and strong exceedingly, and it had great iron teeth. It devoured and brake in pieces, and stamped the residue with the feet of it, and it was diverse from all the beasts that were before it, and it had ten horns. Daniel asked about this fourth beast, then I would know the truth of the fourth beast, which was diverse from all the others, exceeding dreadful, whose teeth were iron, and his nails of brass, which devoured, brake in pieces, and stamped the residue with his feet, the heavenly messenger told him. Daniel 7:23 The fourth beast shall be the fourth kingdom upon earth, which shall be diverse from all kingdoms, and shall devour the whole earth, and shall tread it down, and break it in pieces. Rome followed Greece and was more cruel than any previous kingdom in brutal force. Iron teeth correspond to the iron legs of the image in Daniel chapter 2. The three preceding powers were symbolized by three mighty beasts of prey with resemblance to real animals living upon the earth, but when the fourth beast appeared there was no natural animal with a character to represent its terrible nature, so it is rendered as a terrible beast with iron teeth, brass nails, and ten horns. Concerning the former beasts, the angel tells us that they had their dominion taken away but their lives were prolonged. Each kingdom left behind its principles of worship and government, transmitting them to next power. So it is that when the fourth beast arose, those principles of government and religion were all amalgamated into this terrible beast with super strength. And it had ten horns. Daniel 7:8 I considered the horns, and, behold, there came up among them another little horn, before whom there were three of the first horns, plucked up by the roots, and, behold, in this horn were eyes like the eyes of men, and a mouth speaking great things. Daniel 7:24 And the ten horns out of this kingdom are ten kings that shall arise. This beast has ten horns. We commonly hear that Rome fell in 476 AD, and then look to see which ten tribes conquered Rome. But that is not being true to this prophecy. The ten horns are part of the Roman beast, not new powers that attack it. The pattern which prophetic beasts follow show horns as representing a division within, not a conquering of a nation. For example, the four horns on the goat in Dan 8 depict the four divisions of Greece after Alexander's death. The stout horn we will later more fully identify as the papacy, which received its power from Rome. The other horns also must receive some sort of power and recognition which incorporates them into Rome for them to qualify as